Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and yes, top three Linux-based smartphones. So Android, iOS, Windows phones, and BlackBerry 10 aren't the only smartphone operating systems fighting for a place in your pocket. There are other smartphone operating systems in the market, and they're all Linux-based. Google's Android operating system is also based on Linux, although it's very different from the typical Linux distribution. And top number one on the list, guys, yes, Firefox OS. Now, Firefox OS is Mozilla's attempt to create their own smartphone operating system. It's based on the Firefox browser and Gecko's rendering engine, meaning each app uses web technologies like HTML file to render itself on the phone. Now, Mozilla sees the web as a future application platform for every device. Most computer users use a web browser for most things, but people tend to be, using native applications on smartphones. Now, these applications are confined to a single operating system or even a single app store. Mozilla wants to bring the open web to the smartphones and replace those native applications with web applications. Now, Firefox OS is a bit like Chrome OS for smartphones. And top number two, guys, yes, Ubuntu phone. Yes, beautiful. Now, Ubuntu wants to create a touch-optimized interface that works on smartphones, tablets, and even TVs, making their own OS to be everywhere. Now, the intention is to have a single version of Ubuntu Linux distribution. When installed on a smartphone, you see the touch-optimized interface designed for your screen size. Now, Ubuntu's vision is that the same Unity desktop and Linux software will be running on both devices. Unity will automatically resize and adapt to the screen size and device. Now, this means you could seemingly dock an Ubuntu phone and gain access to a full Linux desktop running on a device, which would be pretty cool. It's an impressive vision, one that tries to combine a full desktop operating system with a mobile operating system. It's a bit like a little bit of Microsoft's vision with Windows phones and Windows 8. It's the same concept of, one operating system that runs the same apps with different interfaces for different devices. And top number three in the list, guys, yes, Samsung Tizen. Now, Tizen is an open source platform generally associated with Samsung. Tizen is actually the umbrella of the Linux Foundation, and both Samsung and Intel are on its steering committee. Samsung's own Android Galaxy devices run the TouchWiz skin with Samsung's own look, and Tizen's looks very similar to TouchWiz. This is clearly a backup operating system for Samsung. If they wanted to leave Google's Android and go in their own direction, they could start pushing Tizen on the next Galaxy S phones. After all, Tizen is designed to look almost exactly like those Galaxy phones do today. Samsung is beginning to ship, a handful of Tizen smartphones nowadays, and the Samsung Galaxy Gear 2 smartwatch also runs Tizen. There's one big problem with Samsung here. Tizen has basically no apps. It isn't compatible with Android apps as of yet. Samsung would have to convince Android app developers to create apps for Tizen if they want to leave Android behind and push their own platform. They wouldn't have Google's apps either. For all we know, Samsung may just be keeping Tizen under their wings as a bargaining chip in their own negotiation with Google. And that's it, guys. Those are my top three Linux-based smartphones so far in the market. I know there's a couple more out there. What's your thoughts about these top threes? Leave your comments right below, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.